Thank you very much, everyone. Welcome to the opening concert of the Academy Orchestra. I'm Jim Sedepin, the director of the Academy. We begin with music by Mozart, a divertimento he wrote when he was the same age as many of the students on stage here, 16. A divertimento is music to enjoy, to divert, to entertain. And this piece has, as you would expect, the high spirits of an adolescent. But Mozart also found music of elegance and grace far beyond his years. Here's a Mozart divertimento.
Thank you.
For those of you who may be new to these concerts, we move the orchestra around for every piece to give everyone a chance to play a little bit higher up and a little bit further back. So now we come to the Austrian composer Anton von Webern. Mr. von Webern wrote a piece which he called, of course, in German, Langsamer Satz, which means slow movement. He wrote this when he was 22 years old, and he was in love. He would take long walks in the springtime in the beautiful Austrian countryside with his cousin, Wilhelmina, whom he later married. So this is music written by a man in love. Listen to the very first phrase of this piece, which starts on the lowest note of the violin, soars up almost three octaves high into the sky, and then gently comes back down to earth. Listen to just the first phrase of this romantic music. So yes, this is very romantic music, passionate, tender, full of ecstasy, and the very ending is music that is just so hushed and sensitive you almost don't want to breathe. Here is Anton von Webern's slow movement.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Prodigies who play string instruments or the piano are not that common, although you see about 20 of them on the stage right now. But composer prodigies, that is, people who create music that you actually want to hear, who are young people, those are as rare as skinny elephants. Sylvia Pine is one of those, a composer prodigy. She wrote this next piece when she was 11 years old last April. It's called Rising Storm, and it's a really fun piece. It starts off, the storm is approaching, starts softly, gets louder and louder, and then we hear the storm in all its full fury. A little later in the piece, we're evidently in the eye of the storm, and then the end of the piece is total chaos. So this is a piece full of character and life. Here is Rising Storm by Sylvia Pine.
Thank you. Thank you.
The tragic murder of so many young black men is a long story in our history. While many people have written words to deplore this situation, one black man, Carlos Simon, composer, has given us a piece of music that allows us to contemplate this experience at a deeper level. The opening phrase of this music, which is played by each section of the orchestra, according to the composer, quote, represents the cry of those struck down unjustly in this country, end quote. While the music is predominantly sorrowful and tragic and contemplative, there are also, according to the composer, moments of extreme hope represented by bright consonant harmonies. Here's Carlos Simon's Elegy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. Well, now we have some very affirmative, happy, vigorous music by Bach. Bach wrote six great works for the Margrave of Brandenburg. He was hoping that this nobleman would give him a job. Brandenburg is a little town just west of Berlin. Well, the Margrave didn't give him a job, probably didn't even look at these six great pieces, and what a loss for Brandenburg and probably for posterity as well. This Brandenburg Concerto is in three movements. The first one is the longest, and it's based on this three-note motive. Da-da-dum. You'll hear that a lot. Da-da-dum, 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 bum-bum. Just keep your ear peeled for that. You won't lose your place. The second movement is very, very short. Bach only wrote two chords, which we embellish with two solo violins here and here. And the third movement has this wonderful, irresistible dance impulse. Here is Bach's third Brandenburg Concerto. Thank you. Thank you all very much for coming. We invite you all, one and all, to a potluck feast in the lobby right after this concert. We close our program with a fun piece by Leroy Anderson, a man who wrote a number of very short, catchy pieces for the Boston Pops Orchestra. This one is called Fiddle-Faddle, and it requires these first violins here to move their arms faster than humanly possible. So wish them all luck.